Good morning.
Morning.
Welcome to worship this morning. A few announcements before we are able to begin worship. First of all, we are not live this morning, but we are recording. So if you know anybody that usually watches us live and texts you and says there's no live stream, we know how to reset a router. We figured out what to do when the sound goes out. When YouTube has a problem, we can't fix that, and apparently YouTube has a connectivity problem this morning. So, but we are recording, and we will upload the worship service after church. You may have noticed that, I heard that chuckle, you may have noticed that there is scaffolding all around the church, which makes parking a little bit of an issue, access to the parking lot a little bit of a change of pace. The only door that is accessible is this one at the gathering area for entry, is the one at the gathering area down here. However, where they are doing shingle removal, which involves asbestos, so when they get in here right next to that section in that door, they will actually need to block all of that off. So for a little bit here, if you need to come up to church for something, it would be a good idea to either call the church office, Dave Bodai, or me, and just see what the situation is with that back door, just to keep everyone safe and avoid any unnecessary asbestos exposure when they're working that closely to the door. They just don't want anybody using it. So we're making progress. This is the real, I said, when the rift and the scaffolding showed up in the parking lot, I said, let the chaos begin. And it has indeed begun, and it is all good. We give thanks today. So, wonderful timing of the Spirit. You may notice that there are a few members of the congregation that are dressed in unusually brightly colored clothing with different patterns, etc. Our choir anthem today is a South African hymn. And it just so happens that our synod, Northwestern Ohio Synod, has a companion synod in Tanzania. It's the Dodoma Diocese, and I know, Monty, it's not Tanzania, but I can't get the correct pronunciation off my tongue after saying Tanzania for so many years. Some of you may remember that it would have been right after I got here that we had a delegation of guests from Tanzania that came and shared their stories and shared worship with us. So today, in Tanzania, in the Dodoma Diocese, they are consecrating a newly elected bishop. Just happens to be today, just happens to be the day that we are singing an anthem that is a South African. So many of us have chosen to wear our brightly colored, African-inspired clothing. Some of us have actually fabric or clothing that came right from Tanzania from some of our companion guests. It occurred to me that none of you would actually think it out of the ordinary that I showed up in a skirt looking like this. I mean, I'm not sure what that says, but you might notice some of our choir members or some of the other members of the congregation have been good sports. Can I pick on you, Monty? Monty, would you please show off this morning? Being a good sport this morning, Pastor Monty has come in full... Tanzania, there we go. Now, do you know how, 65 years of Tanzania, you know how long it's going to take me to say Tanzania? Okay, so we are, you know, delighted that all of this kind of fell into place today, and in our prayers we will indeed pray for our companion synods. The other two are companion synod in Mexico, Lutheran Church in Mexico, and there's a long one about the Slovak Evangelical Lutheran Church of the Augsburg Confession in Serbia and Montenegro, and I might be close. So this is a good time today for us to lift up the fact that we are, in fact, a globally connected church, and what a way to celebrate it. Is there anything else we need to know for worship? Thank you to Jan Labonte for being our accompanist today, and Hunter Grell, who is going to accompany our anthem on bongos. So we have a lot of excitement going this morning.
And sorry, Jean, the community meal is canceled, isn't it?
Yes, yes. Okay, yeah, that's okay.
And sewing
and community meal, yeah, check the weekly calendars, or if someone is kind of a big... part of the ministry, give them a call and double check over the next few weeks just because of access to the building here. All right, do I have anyone that would like to light candles this morning? Come on up, young lady. Let us take a moment and we will quiet our hearts and prepare for worship as we listen to the prelude. Thank you. Please rise as you are able for our thanksgiving for baptism. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, by whose hand we are given new birth, by whose speaking we are given new life. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are welcomed, restored, and supported as citizens of the new creation. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. Holy God, holy and merciful, holy and mighty, you are the river of life. You are the everlasting wellspring. In mercy and might, you have freed us from death and raised us with Jesus, the firstborn of the dead. In the baptismal waters, our old life is washed away, and in them we are born anew. Amen. Glory to you for oceans and lakes, for rivers and streams. Honor to you for waters that wash us clean, quench our thirst, and nurture both crops and creatures. Praise to you for the life-giving water of baptism, the outpouring of the Spirit of the new creation. Wash away our sin and all that separates us from you. Empower our witness to your resurrection. Strengthen our resolve in seeking justice for all. Satisfy the world's need through this living water, where drought dries the earth, bring refreshment. Where despair prevails, grant hope. Where chaos reigns, bring peace. We ask this through Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit reigns forever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you. Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, your Son Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Give us grace to love one another, to follow in the way of his commandments, and to share his risen life with all the world. For he lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our choir anthem.
The first reading from the book of Acts. Filled with the Holy Spirit, Stephen gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. "Look," he said, "I see the heavens opened, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. But they covered their ears, and with a loud shout, all rushed together against him. Then they dragged him out of the city, and they began to stone him. And the witnesses laid their coats at the feet of a young man named Saul. While they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he knelt down and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, he died. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
We'll read Psalm 31 responsively. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness. Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. For you are my crag and my stronghold. For the sake of your name, lead me and guide me.
Take me out of the net that they have secretly set upon me, for you are my tower of strength.
Into your hands I commend my spirit, for you have redeemed me, O Lord, God of truth. Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love. The second reading, a reading from the first letter of Peter. Like newborn infants, long for the pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow into salvation, if indeed you have tasted that the Lord is good. Come to him, a living stone, though rejected by mortals, yet chosen and precious in God's sight. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it stands in Scripture, "See, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone, chosen and precious. And whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you then who believe, he is precious. But for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner, and a stone that makes them stumble and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the word as they were destined to do. But you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of the darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy." Word of God, word of life. Please rise for the gospel.
The Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly, I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask for anything, I will do it." The Gospel of our Lord. Please be seated. Beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, grace and peace to you from God our Father and Jesus our Savior. Amen. The way. You know the way. Sure, we do. Well, my family, growing up, we had a lot of really differently directionally challenged people. My youngest brother growing up went someplace once and he knew exactly, it was familiar, automatically. From the time he was 4 years old, we took one trip to the neighbor's lake somewhere out in the middle of nowhere, and the next time we headed in that general direction, he said, "Are we going to Mackenzie's cottage?" I mean, my friend, why would you say that? He said, "Because this is how we go, and then you turn left here," and he's 4 years old. He went once. It's proved that direct sense of direction ever since. My mother, on the other hand, could not tell her left from the right. So he said, "Mom, hold up your hands. The hand that makes the L is your left one." And my mother went. Or for you guys, right? We shook our heads, gave up, and said, "Never mind, Mom." It was always just, "No, Mom, your other left." My oldest brother, however, was the challenge. We lived 3.5 blocks from his elementary school. One house off the corner, turn right, walk 3.5 blocks, and you would walk right past his school. And every single morning, he would stand on the front porch and throw a temper tantrum because he couldn't go. He was gonna get lost. And every single morning, Mom or somebody would walk into the corner and get him within a half block of the school, and they would go through that forever. And the process would repeat the next morning. "But you know how to get there. We've showed you. We've walked with you." And the temper tantrum would continue. Turns out there was a reason for all that. But the point being that all of us in my family, for one reason or another, no matter how many times we had our issues with directions, left, right, your other left, how many times do we have to show you? And so I'm sitting there thinking of this all week long as I've been pondering the scripture passage. As Thomas says, "Lord, we don't even know where you're going. How are we going to know the way?" And Jesus says, "I've been showing you. I'm it." And Philip says, no. "Show us the Father. Then we'll know." I wonder Jesus didn't pull out his hair at that point in time. Seriously? 3 years, Philip? You've seen me, you've seen the Father. You've seen what I do. You know the way. How many times do I have to say to you, the kingdom of heaven is at hand? Every time we heal, we do miracles, we forgive, we invite the outcasts into our community. How can you not figure out what the way is? And they still didn't get it. And Jesus repeats, believe in it. Believe what you've seen and heard. What I've said, what I do, how I have shown you to how to form community and said to you, the kingdom of God is at hand, is the way. Just believe in it. If it had only been that simple, right? If it had been that simple, something tells me we would not be in the 21st century a church divided into multiple denominations. Christians fighting Christians, Christians fighting Muslims, Christians worried about Jews. If it were as simple as trusting that who Jesus was and what Jesus did was the way of the kingdom of heaven, I don't think we'd be sitting here today doing this quite the same way. But I think we have our own directional issues. This is an interesting passage of Scripture. It's been used and misused a million times, just like many passages of Scripture taken out of context. These are words of comfort from Jesus to disciples who have been told he's going away. And he has said, I have set for you the way. I have set the way before you. And 2,000 years later, we are still discussing, still fighting over, and still questioning, what is it that God wants of me? Follow the way. Remember one time sitting in council and saying, I want to talk about the commandments, the ones Jesus gave us. Love your enemies and pray for them. Love your neighbor as yourselves. Love one another as I have loved you. 3 years of watching Jesus love the outcast, forgive the unforgivable, welcome the stranger, miraculous feedings, and now he claims, look, if you've seen me, you know the Father. If you've seen and what I've done, and if you follow me, you know the way. And with the benefit of 2020 hindsight and a couple thousand years, so do we, my friends. But it's never as simple as it sounds. Ask Stephen, who all he did was do what we're called to do, point to the marvelous acts of God and proclaim that God came in Jesus and rose him from the dead, and it got him stoned. Murdered. Stephen got the way. The last recorded words of Stephen. Lord, do not hold this sin against them. In that moment when his faith was tested beyond life, he prayed not for his own life, but that the Lord would forgive his killers. Apparently, he learned something from the message that Jesus called from the cross, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. We have good hearts, my friends. We want to follow Jesus. I can't see your hearts. But I trust, and I know God does. But sometimes we make it more difficult and complicated than we have to. Because we tend to be all about who's right, who's wrong, who's in, who's out. Who could God possibly love? How could God possibly love? Can't be. Maybe that person is the person in the mirror. Maybe that person is the neighbor who doesn't believe the same way we do. The people down the street that don't believe at all, the heathens. The unchurched. The people at the baseball diamond on Sunday morning. Right? We're all really, really quick to figure out who it is that isn't following the way. As long as that's not us, we're good. That wasn't what Jesus asked his followers to do. He said, follow me. Bear witness to what you've seen. Trust that if you do that, that is the way to the Father. Live the new life and the new community that I have shown you. It's so hard. Jesus never said it would be easy. In fact, he promised them and us that it might be challenging, even fatal. He also didn't say it to each of the individual disciples, but to the disciples gathered as a group. These words were and are intended to be heard as a community. Living out communally, not just individually, communally, our understandings of the kingdom of heaven, the new community that Jesus was creating when God came among us, that is a collective act. We are collectively the living stones, the body of Christ, who will go on to do greater things than even Jesus himself. Every time we gather here on Sunday morning, we make a statement that we come together and we celebrate our oneness that comes not in our language necessarily, not in our political ideations, not in any of our physical attributes or our accomplishments, but in Christ. We make a statement by gathering. We do this when we gather as an extended family and live out the new kingdom where forgiveness is the response to being wronged. Where strangers are only strangers once. Where enemies don't stay enemies very long, because once you start praying for somebody, it's really hard to think of them in that way. We know the way, my friends. And for others to know the way, we need to live it. It is one thing for us to say, Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. But if we can't live, if we can't live the kingdom of heaven that Jesus gave us a glimpse of, our words are a bunch of babble. How often this scripture passage has been used as a hammer to pound the faith into people. And yet, what it really was an invitation, a word of comfort, a word of strengthening and nurturing. You know this. You've got this. You've walked these 3.5 blocks with somebody with you every day for the last 3 years. How do you not know this? I think it has something to do with what Luther calls our simultaneously sinful and yet somehow still justified by God. I just call it the old human ego. It dies hard. But it will go as we live into the way of Jesus that we've been called to follow. We know God. We've heard of God's mighty works in the person of Jesus. We trust in God's promises because of the person of Jesus who comes among us and conquers death and shows us the way. And lest we forget, we get to come here every week and be reminded and reunited and remembered into the body of Christ through bread and wine, water and word. Oh, he is indeed the way and the truth and the life. And we can live the way, trusting in that promise, opening that invitation, living out that comfort. Amen. Please rise for our hymn of the day. I couldn't figure out if we knew this one or not, so Jan, it's probably going to be helpful if you play it through once for us. Words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, of not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human.
For our sake, he was crucified by the fire. He suffered death
and was buried. And on the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who worship the Father and the Son, is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
United in the hope and joy of the resurrection, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. God of community, strengthen your church to proclaim your gospel. We give you thanks for your church around the world, especially our partners in ministry in the Lutheran World Federation. Bless the ministry of our companion synods in the Slavic Evangelical Lutheran Church of the Augsburg Confession in Serbia, Montenegro. The Dodona Diocese of the Evangelical Lutheran Church in Tanzania and the Mexican Lutheran Church. We pray especially for the Dodoma Diocese as today they consecrate newly elected Bishop Christian Nadosa. May the delegates from our own Senate who are in attendance be faithful witness to our bridge-building partnership with them. Grant them traveling mercies for the remainder of their visit and the return journey. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Creating God, you show your steadfast love through mighty waters, towering mountains, fervent fields, and arid deserts. Protect the earth's diverse habitats from the forces of pollution, erosion, extinction, and global warming. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Mighty God, your Spirit guides us into all truth. Give wisdom to world and local leaders and organizations as they begin, build, or renew relationships. Strengthen leaders and aid organizations in areas needed to be rebuilt following conflict, unrest, or natural disaster. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Loving God, you make your home among us. Abide with refugees, those experiencing homelessness, those fleeing war and poverty, and all who question if there is a home in your heart. We pray for all who are sick, especially those on the prayer list of this congregation, and those whom we name now, whether silently or aloud.
Nicole.
Hear us, O God. Assuring God, you accompany your people amid uncertainty and change. Uphold people in this community who have recently moved, changed jobs or schools, retired, or are going through transitions of any kind. Lead us in your ways. Hear us, O God. Rejoice in the victory of Christ's resurrection. We lift our prayers and praise to you, Almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please take a moment and share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Thank you.
let us return to God what God has first given us, ourselves, our time, our possessions, all of these signs of God's gracious love. Please rise.
Meal you offer yourself. We give thanks for these gifts of the earth. In the breaking of this bread, reveal to us the risen one. In the pouring of this wine, pour us out in service to the world. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also
with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior, Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb, who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with earth and sea and other creatures, and with angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, 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 holy
is the day that in joy and delight we join with all the peoples of heaven and all the creatures on earth to sing our praise and thanksgiving to you, all holy and mighty and glorious God, for Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
This is the day that you gave light to the earth. This is the day that you saved the Israelites through the sea and with your pillar of fire led them to freedom. Now every night is as bright as day, and that light is Christ.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day that you broke the chains of death. This is the day that, marrying heaven to earth, you washed away sin, rescued us from evil, and brought us your peace. The Lamb who was slain has begun to reign, for Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
The night before he died, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. On this day, send us the power of your Holy Spirit. Revive us with the body and blood of our risen Savior. Illumine our lives with your presence and shine your morning star over the whole human race, for that light is Christ.
Thanks be to God.
All holy and mighty and glorious God, radiant Father, victorious Son, and shining Spirit, we bless your salvation, we sing of your mercy, and we praise your victory through all time and place. For Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as our Lord Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Come and know Christ, broken and poured out for you. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Please rise as you are able. May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, in you we live and move and have our being. With your word and with this meal of grace, you have nourished our life together. Strengthen us to show your love and serve the world in Jesus' name. Amen.
The God of all, who raised Jesus from the dead, bless you by the power of the Holy Spirit to live in the new creation. Amen. Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Go in peace, serve the risen one.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
And Amelia is delighted to be in church today.
Amen.